Today we have an unusual hero, the Titalic. This creature, which lived about 375 million years ago, has become a real symbol of evolution. Let's figure out that such an amazing creature was so amazing. The Titalic is perhaps one of the most important heroes of ancient life history on our planet. Why? Because it is he who stands at the junction of two worlds, water and terrestrial. Imagine a fish that could not only swim, but also confidently move around shallow water, relying on its powerful fins, almost like paws. Yes, Titalic had amazing limbs, fins, with bones that look like our hands and legs. So why did the fish need to get out of the water? Scientists believe that at that time, the competition in the aquatic environment was very strong, and some animals began to master new niches for survival. Titalic was one of the first such daredevils. His body was perfectly adapted for shallow lead and swampy territories, where he could hide from large water predators and find new food. These were various invertebrates and small animals that lived on the border of water and land. The offspring of the Titalic, as befits real fish, developed in water. However, young individuals quickly acquired the ability to be on land for a short time. This adaptation gave them a huge advantage in survival, because they could avoid danger and look for food in completely new places. The most interesting, the descendants of the Titalic continued to develop these abilities, and gradually they had real limbs that could withstand the body on land for a long time. Thus began the great transition of life from water to land, thanks to which all terrestrial animals appeared in the end, including you, with you. Titalic. This is not just an ancient fish, it is a real evolutionary bridge between the two worlds. Sharks of the Devonian period appeared much earlier than the Titalic, about 400 million years ago, and even then, they were distinguished by an incredible adaptability to life in water expanses. By the way, they were older than the first trees. It turns out that the first tree is 50 million years younger than sharks. Amazing creatures with a streamlined body and sharp teeth, perfectly suitable for capture and retain prey. But why exactly the sharks were so successfully fixed in the role of sea predators? Let's look at this issue from different angles. Firstly, the sharks of Devona possessed several key evolutionary advantages. A cartilage skeleton that made them light and quick, and incredibly sharp teeth that can recover after loss. These features provided them with a significant advantage in survival and hunting. Another important factor, this is vibrant. Unlike most ancient fish, which they put caviar, Tiktaalik gave birth to living cubs. This significantly increased the chances of young animals for survival, as young sharks were immediately ready for active movement and independent nutrition. In addition, the sharks of Devona were the first to form complex hunting strategies. They used their excellent senses, such as smell and sideline, to detect the victim at a great distance. This allowed them to dominate the ecosystem, occupying the upper levels of the food chain. It is also interesting that the appearance of sharks has become an important catalyst for evolutionary processes. Their presence stimulated the development of protective mechanisms in other marine inhabitants, contributing to evolutionary diversity. Let's talk about a very special shark, Claoslakia. Do not worry. The name sounds like something from Greek mythology, but this is really an ancient shark. And yes, today we will find out why she became a real star of her time, long before the sharks began to scare vacationers on the beaches. So, Claoslakia, she lived about 370 million years ago in the Devonian period, when the oceans were a real resort for all kinds of strange creatures. A pretty shark cannot be called. But in the nomination, Best Adaptation to Life, it would be among the winners. Firstly, let's discuss her physique. Claoslakia had a rather elegant silhouette, a slender body, streamlined as a racing car, and a feature that, perhaps, was its main advantage: flexibility and speed. Imagine an ancient oceanic car, ready at any moment to break off and rush to the gaping prey. If she had her own motto, he would have sounded something like this: the fastest. Otherwise, you will remain hungry. Now about the teeth. In the Pantoslakia, the teeth were small but very sharp, ideally suitable for catching small and mobile prey, such as small fish and cephalopods. Not the most formidable weapon, but quite effective for its lifestyle. She was, one might say, Germin of the Devonian period. No coarse food, only small, exquisite sea cuisine. By the way, the Tretislakia was one of the first sharks to use live up. That is, the cubs were born already completely prepared for an independent life. The sharks immediately settled down, like small missiles, ready to hunt for everything that was moving, and were careful enough to be eaten. Parents were probably proud of them, although it is not customary for the sharks to take care of the offspring for a long time. Young Pantoslakia immediately received complete freedom of action. If you think about it, the Pantoslakia has become an important milestone in the history of sharks, paving the path for many species that live in the oceans today. And let it not be so waking as modern white sharks, or so bizarre as a Helicoprion with its tooth spiral. But she knew exactly what it was to be a successful predator of the Devonian period. Imagine a shark, but not just a shark, but a predator who decided that ordinary teeth were too boring and trite. Instead of a jaw usual with rows of teeth, Helicoprion had something completely unusual: tooth spiral. A whole spiral of teeth resembling a circular saw, which was located right inside its lower jaw. But let's talk seriously. Why did the Helicoprion need such a design? Scientists raised their heads for a long time, trying to understand how he could eat and survive with such a device in his mouth. It is assumed that Helicoprion used this spiral to deftly cut soft squids and other cephalopods, which he probably ate. Too complicated device for a shark. Why fence such a garden? We are not clear, but nature probably had their own plans for this shark. Another interesting aspect: this is the size of the Helicoprion. Some species have reached a length of up to 23 feet, which makes it even more impressive and, say, a frightening character of the sea world. Fortunately for us, these unusual creatures lived about 290 million years ago, so the chance to meet them today is zero. We have enough ordinary sharks. Interestingly, Helicoprion has long remained a mystery to paleontologists. At first, the finds of his spiral teeth were so strange that they were even mistaken for some mysterious ancient shells. Only relatively recently, scientists finally figured out who belonged to these dental spirals and introduced the Helicoprion to the world in all its absurd glory. Shark Ginsa, or scientifically, Cretoxoxen. Why is it called that? And what was special in this sea inhabitant? Let's figure it out. So, the shark Ginsa, or Cretoxoxen, lived about 100 million years ago in the late Cretaceous period. It was not in vain that I got its name, reminiscent of a set of kitchen knives. After all, her teeth were a real work of art, long, sharp, and incredibly effective. If there was a rating of the most formidable smiles of the Mesozoic, it would definitely take the first place. But why precisely Gins? If you remember the advertisement of knives that cut absolutely everything, then the shark Gins could well act as an advertising agent of such products. Her teeth were so sharp and durable that they easily cut out the flesh and even the bones of its prey. These were real universal instruments of the Mesozoic seas. The length of the shark Gins reached 23 feet, which made it one of the largest predators of her time. Her diet was very diverse. She ate almost everything that fell she is on her way, from large fish and cephalopods to small sea reptiles. If you were in the ocean at that time, you would clearly not want to catch the eye of this shark if you just do not like extreme. Humorous speaking, Shark Ginsa was a kind of sea chef. She has always been ready for cutting and cutting any prey. Imagine it as a kind of restaurant critic who does not choose what exactly is. The main thing is the speed and effectiveness of the absorption of the dish. From the point of view of the evolution of Shark Ginsa, it was extremely successful. It flourished over millions of years, and its existence pushed other marine inhabitants to develop new survival strategies. Imagine that you are a small fish of that time, and your main incentive for evolution is not to become a breakfast of Shark Ginsa. Motivation, I must admit, is very convincing. The real giant of the ancient oceans, Dunkelly. The name sounds impressive, right? This is an ancient fish that could inspire Hollywood to create a blockbuster of horror. But what is really hiding behind this loud name? Let's figure it out. The main part. So imagine the ocean about 360 million years ago, in the Devonian period. Dunkelly reigned in these waters. Giant shellfish, the size of a small bus, its length could reach 30 feet. And the jaws were so powerful that he easily bought even the most durable armor of other inhabitants of the ocean. Seriously, the jaws of Dunkleosteus deserve a separate conversation. Instead of his usual teeth, he had huge bone plates with sharp edges, which worked as giant scissors or nippers. Imagine a shark that has giant scissors instead of teeth. It sounds creepy, right? And the most funny, these teeth have never stupid. They were simply constantly updated and grew up again and again. Why did nature decide to give Dunkleosteus such an unusual design? The answer is simple. It was an ideal tool for survival in the conditions of brutal competition of the Devonian period. Dunkelly ate everything that he could catch, from large fish to mollusks and even small sharks. His hunting strategy was simple. A powerful attack from an ambush, a lightning throw, and a sharp blow with jaws. From the point of view of the ancient ocean menu, he was a gourmet with very broad preferences. It is also interesting that despite his frightening appearance and incredible power, Dunkelly was not a particularly quick swimmer. He relied on the effect of surprise and his great power. We can say that it was such an ancient ocean terminator, slow, but incredibly effective and persistent. So Dunkelly was not just a large predator, but a real evolutionary sensation of his times. His amazing adaptations allowed him to become the top of the food chain of the ancient seas. And although today we are glad that we cannot meet him live, it is worth admitting that Dunkelly has left an indelible mark on the history of life on Earth. Did you like the video? Put your finger up and leave the comments. And also subscribe to the channel and click on the bell so as not to miss new and interesting videos from the Real Unreal channel.